Bananas are an important staple food and cash crop throughout Africa's Great Lakes region. More than half of the total bananas produced in Africa come from this region. The region hosts a special type of cooking banana known as matoke, which is harvested and cooked while still green. Matoke represents 71% of all bananas produced in the region. It contributes $4.3 billion annually to 20 million resource-poor farmers. Uganda, where the crop is a major staple food, is one of the top producers and consumers of bananas worldwide, particularly matoke. The average matoke consumption per person in the country is 230 to 450 kilograms per year.
When we talk about bananas, many people understand the dessert type, especially Cavendish. But in East and Central Africa, especially in Uganda, banana means matoke because it's our daily food.
Yeah, banana being an important crop in the country, many farmers want to grow it. But when you look at the productivity of bananas, it is very low. Currently, the productivity of bananas stands at 10 tons per hectare per year. But the potential yield should be 60 tons per hectare per year. So there is a big gap between the actual productivity and the potential. And there is a number of factors responsible for that yield gap. The number one is the weevil. Then there is the problem of nematodes. Then there is Brax gatoka, then other factors that include drought and poor agronomic management practices.
Ebi sibu bya tulina ebi tusange bya matoke gano agafe agakansangwao nti ebiuka bibilya nnyo. So bilina n'obulwadde obujja ku ndagala n'amatoke gennyini
To save this important food and cash crop, the International Institute of Tropical Agriculture and Uganda National Agriculture Research Organization joined forces in 1992 to breed improved varieties of matoke that are pest and disease resistant. Banana breeding is labor intensive, time consuming, and requires a lot of space. A breeding program requires at least 12 hectares of land, since each plant occupies 6 to 9 square meters. Breeding entails seed production. However, as with most bananas, matoke varieties are mostly sterile and seedless, and natural seed germination is very poor. Therefore, breeders have to go through a long and complicated process of producing banana lines that are fertile and produce more seeds. In the matoke improvement process, the local varieties are crossed with fertile diploid bananas to develop tetraploid lines, which are fertile and produce more seeds. Tetraploid lines are then crossed with an improved diploid to produce potential cultivars, which are again seedless but carry the required resistance.
Traditional matoke and their derived tetraploid lines are used as the female parents, and the diploids, which are the donors of the genes to resistance of pests and diseases, are used as the male parents.
Pollination of the female parent with pollen from the male parent is done by hand early in the morning. Each bunch is pollinated for 7 to 15 days. After pollination, a bunch takes 3 to 4 months to mature and then is harvested. It is left to ripen, then the seeds are extracted and taken to the tissue culture laboratory, where the embryos are carefully removed and germinated. After about 6 months, the germinated embryos have now become rooted plantlets and are transferred to the humidity chamber for 3 to 4 weeks for weaning. They are then transferred to the screenhouse for another 2 to 3 months before they are planted in the field. Here, the plants are rigorously evaluated for yield capability, resistance to pests and diseases, and other agronomic traits, with more than 90% of them being eliminated in the process. Acceptability by end users is another vital assessment that potential cultivars undergo.
We cut out sensory evaluation of bred bananas basically to control the quality of the bread materials. And we do this at two levels. We do it in the lab, at lab level. We focus on the R evaluation of the newly crossed materials in R evaluation trials. And the materials that pass sensory tests at laboratory level are advanced for field evaluations. And in the field, we do sensory evaluations again with a larger number of consumers at farm level. So it's materials that pass both levels that are advanced for release.
The process of developing a new Matoke hybrid through pollination, germination, field evaluation, and selection results in a long breeding cycle. It takes about 2 decades to develop and release a new variety. Despite these challenges, NARO and IITA have collaboratively produced 27 Matoke hybrids dubbed Naritas after NARO and IITA. These hybrids were selected for their resistance to black sigatoka as well as high yield. One of these, the Narita 7, or Chiwangazi as it's called by farmers, has been released in Uganda.
Ebitoke ebyo fengaffe abalimi twabituuma Kiwangazi, bitukoledde bulungi nnyo. Nti ebitoke ebyo ne bw'oba tobitaddeeko nnyo okulabirira kw'amaanyi, bisigala bikuwa. Era nkubiriza abantu abatannaba kukifunako naddala kino M9 bakisimbe, kubanga tekirina njawulo na bitoke ebirala byonna, era testi yakyo nungi nnyo, kiwooma emmere okukamala obukamazi.
The 27 Naritas have undergone additional multi-environmental evaluation in Uganda and Tanzania with support from regional and international partners. From this evaluation, 4 Naritas have been selected by farmers. The future looks even more promising. IITA and its partners are focusing on shortening the banana breeding cycle so that hybrids are given to farmers in a much shorter time than it took to avail the first Naritas using marker-assisted selection. This makes use of molecular tools to analyze the DNA composition of the plants while in the screenhouses to select those that have inherited the desired traits from their parent genes. Only those that test positive proceed to further field evaluation. This eliminates at least one level of field evaluation, saving time and space.
For the last 5 years, as IITA, together with many other partners, including NARO and many others, we've been working on developing molecular tools to be used in banana breeding. I've worked on QT analysis for pests and diseases, such as weevils, nematodes, fusarium, and I've worked also on testing predictive models for yield traits and other agronomic traits we can be evaluated in the field. And these are very promising. I've found very good results. What's going to happen now is that they're going to validate them, then we can use them in breeding.
IITA is not focusing on innovation alone. It is also ensuring sustainability by training the next generation of banana scientists. Several masters and PhD graduates have benefited from the program's funding and scholarships. The big picture is to sustainably enhance food security and improve the livelihoods of East and Central Africans.